addiction is a very persistent behavior which leads to the loss of control over one's life. And the biggest problem is that it's also a very rigid strategy to cope with stress, with anxiety, with difficult emotions. So people who are addicted, they don't develop other more adaptive strategies to cope with their life problems, different issues, and they stick to this very one problematic behavior which overwhelms all other significant life areas and destroys their families, destroys their significant relations, friendships, professional life, education, and passions. And every year there is about 11% of population who suffer from different addictions, substance addictions, behavioral addictions like gambling. So we can say that one of every 10 people has a problem with substances. The big problem we are struggling with is efficiency of addiction treatments right now. Because with the current methods of treatments, like psychotherapy, only about 50% of people are able to finish the treatment. And among those who complete the treatment, majority relapse. So in case of heroin or other opioids, for example, the relapse rate within the next 2 years is about 80%. So if there is 10 people who completed the addiction treatment, 8 of them will relapse, come back to addictions, and 20% of them will die during the next year after completing the treatment. So this is a very serious issue. In case of alcohol, it's about 65 to 70%. And why is it like that? We can say, okay, it's like that because addiction is so persistent and so severe, and we just can't do anything else. Or maybe we just don't understand what addiction is. And if we would understand it better, then maybe we would be able to provide a better treatment, more effective. So what we are trying to do is to look into the brain using all the new technologies. And figure out how the addiction works. And we already know that addiction is not a one problem. There may be a few different brain circuits involved in addiction development. And we need to be able to recognize which circuits are problematic, are causing those problematic behaviors in the particular cases. And then if we are able to identify that, we can provide a very personalized targeted treatment. And right now we are about launching a new studies where we would like to test new treatment methods like transcranial magnetic stimulation. So with the magnetic field, we can try to alter the brain functions in some brain areas and, for example, help to quit the substance of abuse. But also we are using new technologies like smartwatches to support the maintenance of abstinence. So if someone already completed the treatment, it's important to be able to maintain sober. And one of the way to do that is to recognize the everyday patterns of behavior. And for example, if those patterns are changing in some alerting way, then we can warn the person that something wrong is going on and help to, for example, change the behavior before the relapse happens. So those are the common, the most modern ways to study addictions right now.